I'm excited to talk about the Ten of Cups. And the reason I'm excited to talk about the Ten of Cups is just look at this rainbow right here in the shape of a snake. And anyone who studies Kundalini energy, right, we know that this energy is at the base of your spine coiled up, and it's supposed to come up your spine like a snake. And if you actually look at the spine, your spine actually looks like a snake. If you look at the bottom of the tailbone, that would be the head, and then you consider the spine the body and the length of the actual snake. So it's just really beautiful how we see snakes in spirituality. It's very different to a Christian concept of snakes. But just nice to get a different point of view on it. Not that I'm saying that either is right or wrong. Just the difference in point of view, I think, is really, really beautiful. And that's the kind of thing that I live for in my research. Getting just a whole different perspective on things. And seeing things in a different way and in a new light, right? So let's get to the Ten of Cups. I have here the 9, which is a beautiful story you guys can check out. But let's go to the 10. Oshunmare, the rainbow snake, Nigeria. So this particular concept comes from Nigeria, the Yoruba rainbow spirit, also known as Oshunmare, the rainbow serpent. Now, did you know that whenever you see a rainbow, it is actually a multicolored snake spirit stretching strangely across the sky? Wow, how cool is that? Oshunmare is one of the Orishas. He can reach so far across the sky that he managed to reach Brazil and elsewhere to become the colorful voodoo fertility spirit, Idawedo Oshunmare. Okay? And I think what's so cool too is that he's actually also in the world card. If you know the world card in this deck, and let's see if we can find it real quick. Let's go ahead and look at this. 10, as we know, is the completion of a cycle. The 1 and the O representing the womb, the 1 representing the phallus, the womb and the phallus together, which would then create the 2. If you study numerology, it would be 0, 1, and then the 2, right? Let me see if I can find the world here. Ah, here we go. Now, let me make sure. Now, you can see the snake here as well. And the world card is all about completion, graduation. The basically like a clap on the back. Like, good job, you finished a cycle. It could be a karmic cycle. It could be really any type of cycle, right? So let's look into this. You see, let me get the name, because if you've been following these stories from last year, you know that these cards can like two cards from two separate parts of the minor arcana or even the major arcana, they can coexist together in one story. So let's see. Yes, we have Oduduwa, who took over from his brother Obatala the task of completing the creation by Olorun, which is also in Nigeria. So all these characters basically are part of the story of the Orishas in Nigeria. So I know many people study the Orishas and Yoruba and that system of spirituality, religion, etc. So please put what you know down in the description box below. I personally don't practice it. I'm just here to basically show you guys the deeper depths of the cards and the research that I've found. So if you can get some connection between these two, I would love to hear what you all think down below. And of course, the Orishas have such a huge impact in this deck overall, so keep looking for that information. I definitely want to do a separate video on that, just because the Orishas in general is just so much depth that it needs its own video, and we need to look at all the cards that deal with that particular storyline in Nigeria and in Yoruba faith. Okay, so I hope this sparks your imagination, brings more light into your readings. again, even the rainbow in this, I'm thinking about the seven chakras with the Kundalini energy as well. So that's absolutely beautiful. That's so cool. All right. And look, he's in the sky. He's in the sky. They're both in the sky. Yeah, I would just really love to hear a deeper perspective of this from someone who truly practices their faith. So definitely let me know in the comment section below, okay? All right. Peace, y'all, and see you in the next video.